Welcome to your Saturday night. My name's Keegan, and this is Made in Texas Live in Studio. This weekend, I have invited a special guest. He has got his debut single and album just released, Woke Up in Waco. Garrett Ford, man, thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
So let's start off. Let's talk about the new album. It's a 10-track album released, just became available yesterday, but you've been doing kind of a pre-release for the coming weeks going into this. So Talk a little bit about the album, Woke Up in Waco.
So like you say, we've just been plugging in 4 CD release parties over, you know, the last week or two. Just kind of giving folks a early opportunity to buy it before it comes out digitally, full everywhere, September 14th on, you know, Spotify and all the platforms and stuff like that. And it's been kind of the first project. Some of these songs are a few years old and some are, you know, 2 or 3 months old. And I wanted to save up my money, you know, after college and finally put together a first project. And this is something I think it stands its own 2 feet and I'm proud of it. And I know I was really happy to get so many friends and family involved with it, either, you know, on the cover of it.
How or so? Just,
so the front cover, you know, it's just my truck and I've got my little 13 brother, all of his friends chase me on bicycles like Stranger Things or E.T., you were talking about. And it's just been fun to kind of get everyone together and being from Georgetown. It's honestly an awesome suburb at this point. But it's been good seeing everyone kind of come together. And anytime I can pull out a guitar and it brings people together, whatever, that just solidifies why I love what I do.
What can people expect from the album?
I think you're going to hear lyrics, hopefully, that are pretty, you know, cut to the point and straight up. I don't think they're going to... I didn't want to, you know, stray too close to a cliche kind of theme or whatever, but it's really just what I knew. I don't think I can BS stuff very well. So, and in Texas, I think Texas crowd can kind of sniff that out.
Yeah, sure.
So I think you're going to hear some fun truths, maybe about kind of the ballad of being kind of running a little too fast in your 20s and learning stuff the hard way or running out of gas or all sorts of stuff I've done. So
now there is a quote on your website. Garrett-Ford.com is where you can go, all of you guys out there in radio land. But there's a quote here. Did you write this? Good intentions, bad decisions, low on gas and high on the weekend. There's plenty more. I'll leave it for you guys to find on your own. But did you write this quote?
I did.
That's on your website. Where did it come from?
I just wanted to put together something to kind of, it was part of that press release I wrote, just kind of a quick little idea of the single coming out, Woke Up in Waco. That's kind of the theme on that. Just kind of a good guy who tries his best, but maybe ends up in some rough places in the morning and, maybe he needs to grow up a little bit, but he can't let go of his Saturday nights. Now I've read about this guy. I don't know this guy personally.
None of it's from experience, right?
Oh, hell no.
Now, okay, a little bit further down, this as well is just good writing. Talking about getting punched in the mouth.
Mm.
Is that you as well?
That's, yeah.
So where does your writing come from? Where are you finding your inspiration?
I just sat
just
down.
Everywhere?
I don't know. I just sat down one day. I needed a website. I wanted to put some stuff on there to hopefully draw people in or kind of give an idea of kind of what the music can kind of, you know, wrap some words and literature around the music stuff. When I like to go on websites, I want to see stuff, you know, substance stuff. So I think I sat down a day or two and wrote some stuff down on my notepad.
Yeah.
I love the legal pads. I'll just write everything down.
Really? So you're old school. You're not typing it on your phone or an iPad or anything. You're going
old
school.
I'll do some
stuff
on the phone but I lose phones all the time, but I swear I never lose a legal pad.
Really? Interesting.
Just,
okay.
That's my life. So, but yeah, just scribble stuff down. I thought of that. Most of that, all this planning was when I still had an 8-to-5 job. And so I did a lot of daydreaming at the desk.
What'd you do? What was
I
your
8-to-5? I did real estate for a billboard company in Austin.
Really?
So
okay.
It was flexible. I always got to make my gigs and go around town all the time. And I was joking with them. I was like, you guys want to put the album on that big old I-35 billboard out there? And they were like, yeah, that'll substitute your salary for that. Those boards go a lot.
Oh, yeah.
But they've been good and this kind of helped me finance this project. So it's been exciting, kind of scary, you know, the first month and a half, kind of just plugging this in, doing this full time, but it's always been the goal, you know?
Yeah. How long have you known this is what you wanted to do full time?
I think I've kind of found that probably at my first or second concert I went to. And I think the first one, I get them mixed up, is either Frank Irwin Center in Austin, Texas. Either it's Tim McGraw or Alan Jackson, like 2001.
Okay.
And that's when I started picking up guitar and playing and stuff. But I think when I started chasing was when I started writing, because that kind of goes into that farther threshold, I feel like, of when you're like, of commitment. You're like, you know, wow, I really like this, you know. And then you're going to, you know, get tied more in this awesome Texas music scene we have. And being in Austin, us kids saw concerts all the time. And
absolutely, yeah. The tremendous music scene there.
And still, if I'm even like tired or kind of burnt out or like, oh man, it's just, it is tough, you know. I'll go to a concert and that just recharges my battery. Seeing a good band, really? Like, oh yeah, for sure. I think like does that with a lot of people. And so that makes me want to get out there more every time I see a good show.
Who's the latest you've seen?
Who did I see? I think I went to Lone Star Jam.
Did you really?
And that was like a few months ago. And that was straight up the hottest concert outside. Huge lineup, 2-day lineup. It was either Labor Day or Memorial Day. I get those 3-day weekends mixed up.
Memorial Day.
Yeah.
Yeah, Labor Day just happened.
Yeah,
but
that's right. Dove hunting dove.
Oh, so you're a dove hunter?
Yes, sir.
Did you go? Did you make it out?
Yeah, I did. I played 2 shows, but I went to Junction from Austin and then back and played San Antonio. But I went between shows and hunts and then after. But with my buddies from high school.
How'd you do?
I did good. I only shot 3, but I shot 3 shells. So
oh, there you go.
I like 100%.
Good for you.
Yeah, dove hunting's very undisciplined. It's easy. We could sit here with a guitar. We could have a small speaker.
Oh, yeah.
We could have a brisket smoking, and they're still going to fly over. It's not
delightful.
And, you know, versus deer hunting, you know, 5:30, 5:30, it's coming up. You know, and so I love that. And they're easy to clean, and who doesn't love a dove popper?
I don't know. I have not met those people, and I don't want to meet those
Someone
people.
Someone brings that to a tailgate, 45 seconds. Gone, I don't care how big the plate is. Gone.
Gone.
I made 100 one time for an Aggie tailgate, and it was gone, and, you know. 2 poppers a second, maybe.
Oh, in a heartbeat.
Mm-hmm.
Now, talk a little bit about that. You went to A&M. What'd you go to A&M for?
I did ag business.
Okay.
Yep.
And you ended up moving back, kind of back to Austin, or your hometown's Georgetown.
Did nothing remotely close with that.
Yeah. And I know Bryan College Station has a really decent music scene as well.
Mm-hmm.
Why so much? Why go back home? As opposed to stay there and kind of cultivate that. But, you know, just curious.
I honestly think either could have worked.
Yeah.
I know there's a lot more good session players and stuff I met in Austin. And it was quick to record, or if a guy ever, you know, dropped out of a gear, it was easy to find people around Austin.
Yeah.
But it's funny, half of them bands still College Station, you know, we met in college or whatever, and we stuck with it. But, you know, it's funny. I think there is a lot of country players in College Station. I've grown, you know. I know there's been a lot of, the Tap's been great, booking a lot more now. When I was there, it was more kind of piano bar kind of, but they've done a really good job of doing song swaps now and getting big bands out there. And Hurricane Harry's always been great out there. But that was a good place to go to college and play my kind of music, because it fits under that umbrella perfectly.
Absolutely.
And people loved it. We played so many tailgates and out in Northgate and all that. And College Station likes country, for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, so let's hear your first song. What are you going to play for us?
All right, let's see here. I'm going to probably do first one, favorite song. I think probably the last one I wrote, and I believe it should be the second single here. It's called Been to California. Now, you got all these Californians that always move to Austin, and they're all... loving Austin stuff, but I went to California here, and I told them I kind of like it too. I think this song should be single number 2 on our album here. It's called Been to California.
Seen the stars, Lord, I've seen the lights. Pretty people on Rodeo Drive. They love avocados on their toast. They put the top down and they hit the coast. I've been to California. I looked everywhere. I've been looking for you, but you weren't there. I pulled the top down on the 405. been looking for you. I've been to California. Feel morning dew on a canvas tent. An old canteen with a horse hoof dent. Been on months of the strong back of a quarter horse with two saddlebags. I've been to Colorado. I looked everywhere like a desperado. But you weren't there. I took every trail to the top. Standing there, I've been to Colorado. But you weren't there. I've taken the long way to my heart. And miles more from where you are. Been to California. Oh, I looked everywhere. I've been looking for you, but you weren't there. Top down on the 405, feeling the air. I've been looking for you. I've been to California. Hey, I've been looking for you. I've been to California.
Garrett Ford is our guest. The album Woke Up in Waco is out and available now. That is your next single, you're hoping?
I think it should be, and I need to talk and think about promoting, but I think I want that to be my number two single, yes, sir.
Yeah, I dig it, man. Where did you actually travel to all those places? Have you been to California? Have you been to Colorado? Have you done all that?
Yes, sir. Yeah, definitely. And
what took you to Cali?
Recently, I wrote a little before, but I went out to Newport Beach for my uncle's wedding.
Okay.
And I just love how everybody just wears t-shirts, flip-flops, and just chilling. Leaving the doors open was the biggest thing I saw.
That's
this
terrifying.
Summer. Because here, you know, you get hit in the back of the head by your mom. Don't run up the AC bill.
Yeah, right?
Back there and just chilling out, and that was cool. And in Austin, I kind of say, you know, all you Californians come in here and stuff, and everyone
Absolutely.
Always gets a kick
yeah.
out of that. But I'm like, it's not bad up there either.
Yeah.
I think we got friendly folks down here, though. We'll just say that.
You recorded Woke Up in Waco at Yellow Dog Studios there in Wimberley?
Yes, I did it at Yellow Dog, and then I did the other half of it at Cedar Creek Recording in South Austin.
Why'd you split between the two?
I bought 3 days for Cedar Creek Recording, and I had Adam Motor, who owns Yellow Dog Studios in Wimberley. And so we did our 3 days of just tracking instruments at Cedar Creek.
Okay.
And then we just did vocals and steel and I believe Hammond at Yellow Dog Studios.
I got to ask, which one did you like more?
Cedar Creek's beautiful in there. I mean, it was cool to see how many people on the wall, but Yellow Dog's had a lot of people too. But
yeah.
I loved Yellow Dog because it was out off the river at Wimberley.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a river rat, water guy at heart. I wear swim trunks half the year. So I liked it out there. It's very, I think half of the studio, I mean, it sound good, but it just puts you in that calm vibe, you know?
Yeah.
Under those big trees out there on the river. And hearing turkeys out in the woods and stuff was pretty easy to feel like home.
All right, let's talk about it. We already talked a little bit about dove hunting. What else do you do in your free time besides float the river? Because that's, you already said that. What else are you doing?
I'll go out to see shows a lot. It's funny, the older I get, the more I get into like cooking and grilling and dad stuff. I respect that now. You know, when I was little, I'd throw a Pop-Tart, get on the run, and we're going.
Sure.
But now I'm like, you know, Sunday sounds like I'd smoke a chicken a day and chill out or whatever.
Good for you, man.
So I've been having fun doing that. But if I'm not playing, I really want to get out and go see another show or go see another band or something for
yeah.
sure. And Austin's been good. I love going to some of the old staples, Continental Club and
mm-hmm.
and Antones and Bourbon Spoke and, you know, always catching stuff.
Sure.
It's exhausting how many bands are around, you know, with just the bands all the time. I'm always looking and I'm like, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, any day. And I'm like, so I like doing a lot of stuff. I go kayaking a lot now too. So
are you? You're a kayaker too?
Yeah. I kind of live down by Town Lake. So it's super easy just to go down there for at least even an hour or two. So
Garrett Ford is our guest. You can find him online. Garrett-Ford.com is his website. Let me get you doing the next song. What are you going to play for us?
This one, let's do Repaint These Walls. When I was at summer school, I think my junior year at A&M, I worked part-time at Sherwin-Williams Paint Store in Bryan, Texas. And I was kind of working the front desk or shaking up paint for customers, and I had a couple come in, and they wanted the right shade of red, or the wife did. The husband didn't care.
No,
you know,
he didn't care. He just knew he had to put it on the
wall.
She
ain't happy. No one's happy.
Yeah.
And they kept coming in. She came in maybe, I don't know, they both came in a few times over the past 2 weeks. She was picking, we had to get the right shade, it wasn't there. And then they stopped coming after, you know, a few days, and I'm like, okay, I must have finally got it. I guess did my job finally. And then he came in alone, kind of looking like a mess, and was asking for blue. And so I was like, you know, I don't want to ask anything or pride or anything. And so, he was simple, just a shade of blue. And so I did that. And so I went home and he had me thinking on that. You know, we're all thinking. So I went home and I wrote this kind of old country kind of standard, Repaint These Walls.
Think I might repaint these walls. I think I might buy a dog. Grow some tomatoes. My back lawn, I might repaint these walls. Think I might move back home. I know my dad is getting old. There's only so much you can say on the phone. I might move back home. Touch of you, the bathroom town, and these bed sheets, the sound, and winter when the ceiling creaks. Oh, I'm gonna fight the fall. I think I might repaint these walls. I think I might start a band. Get lost with the pedal man. Sing these songs with these two hands. I might start a band. Maybe I'll head back to church. Lord knows my reasons were. Yeah, I've been broken and I've been hurt. Go back to church. How in the world can I pull this through when the whole damn house has got the touch of you? The bathroom town and these bed sheets, the sound in a winter when the ceiling creaks. So I'm gonna fight the fall. I think I might repent. Walls. Oh, I'm gonna fight the fall. I think I might repaint these walls.
He is Garrett Ford, online at garrett-ford.com. Our guest this evening, this is Made in Texas, live in studio. That was a very pretty song.
Thank you.
And I wanted to talk about your guitar.
Mm-hmm.
You have a, for the folks at home, you have a triangle in the middle versus the traditional round. Now, how did this come to be? How did you come to choose this guitar? Where did it come from?
I think when I was in fifth grade, my mom told me and my younger brother about a year, you know, I'm going to learn guitar, and one of my boys, I'm going to be darned if one of my boys don't learn guitar and play me songs in my living room for me. And we were both trying to be Pop Warner stars and okay. try to go to the NFL, the National League, of
course.
Yeah. And so, but she forced us in, and so we started doing it, and we got a cheap little youth guitar, and then she got this Gretsch acoustic guitar, and it's a beautiful guitar, and she's been so busy, you know. Probably washing grass stains out of our clothes, and we put her through a whirlwind, and so she stopped taking lessons and everything, and the more serious I got, you know, I was like, guys, this is a good guitar. I mean, can I make this? They said sure. So I've had it since then, and it's been through a few bands, and so since 2005. Its first band it was in, I was in a Beatles cover band in fifth grade.
Were you really?
It was a Halloween idea, but we all knew how to play. There's a lot of old folks in Georgetown, so nothing cuter than a bunch of fifth graders in turtlenecks playing him half decent. So,
right. Oh, yeah.
Hard Day's Night and everything.
Now, is your family musical in any way? Like,
my mom sings. My dad can't carry a tune in a bucket.
Okay.
But my mom's... On her side of the family, my grandpa was a banjo picker, and they were all from Iowa, and so they would just get around on the porch all the time and do that. So it's definitely my mom's side, for sure, I think.
Okay.
So, but yeah, my dad's side, his family would come and listen to my mom's family, probably. They'd be in lawn chairs during. They weren't the singers.
Garrett Ford is our guest. This is Made in Texas live in studio. He's got a brand new album out. Woke Up in Waco is the title. It is available as of yesterday on your major digital platforms. Of course, the single Woke Up in Waco, you can hear right here on Made in Texas Radio. Talk a little bit about the writing for the album as a whole. How did you come to, because we haven't heard it here. All we've heard is the single.
Sure.
So we haven't had a chance to listen to it. I'm curious to listen to it because what we've heard so far today is, I dig it. I like it. I like what I'm hearing.
Thanks.
I think it's got legs. So that's, you know, good for you, man. Congratulations on that. Thanks. Talk a little bit about the writing of, because 10 tracks. How was all of this coming in and creating this and then being able to push it and you know, go on these radio tours and these things that you're doing, these live concerts and all this stuff that goes along with it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I think it all starts with just writing. And
what's your writing style? How do you
drive around? And
okay,
think in your head
is it? It's just kind of an organic process. Some people have to be in an office, in you know, or some people can be in a duck blind somewhere. I mean, it differs for everybody. So
it's never been a place. I guess it's always been honestly. I guess in your truck's a place. Just driving around though, or just you know having time to pass or whatever, and then. If something comes up or something, you kind of just record real quick on your phone or whatever it is, either lyrics or melody.
Yeah.
And then when you have time, you kind of round up all that stuff together at your desk maybe and then see what you can do with it, you know. But I don't have a set thing real quick. It's kind of maybe kind of what hits you at that time. Make sure you just remember it or record it or something and then run with that later. Don't just throw it away in the closet.
Well, you mentioned something earlier a little bit. About some of these songs being a little bit older. Mm-hmm. I think you said some of them are as much as 5 years old.
Yeah.
How many songs do you have that aren't showing up on this album? And why did you choose the ones that did?
Yeah, no, good question. There's like a bunch, you know, I kind of always think of it as like, you know, your coach and you got your front 11 you got to put on the field or something. There's a depth chart and some kids are going to get cut.
Sure, sure.
There was definitely a lot, you know, I had to narrow down the list from you know, maybe 40 to 30 and then 15. And then, you know, I thought 13 would be great, but you know, at some point, you know, recording's expensive and everything and 10's plenty, I think. And so, you don't want everything to kind of sound the same or whatever. So maybe different ideas or different themes or kind of, I like to say there's something in it for everybody. You know, there's some 2 a.m. two-steppers, like Repaint These Walls, or then there's some more upbeat, fun stuff, like Been to California, Woke Up in Waco. So
yeah,
there's something, like, you know, for everyone there. My album's like Luby's. There's something for everybody there.
Your album's like Luby. I love it. I love it, man. I Let's go ahead and get you to play that cover.
Okay.
What are you going to play for us? And it can be anything. We have had just about anything in here. Everything.
I think if I still had a MySpace, this would be a MySpace song.
That's
the
my
best
God.
Way I can say it. It
you,
explains
You remember
me.
MySpace? Oh.
You know what people do? They chose a song that...
Yeah, oh, well, I remember.
That's what I'm going through right now.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I'll do.
Once was thought inside my head, for I'd reach 30, I'd be dead. But somehow on and on I go, keep on rolling with the flow. Folks said that I would change my mind, I'd straighten up and do just fine. Oh, but I still love rock and roll, keep on rolling with the flow. While guys my age are raising kids, I'm raising hell just like I did. I've got some wild and crazy friends who forgive me of my sins. Some might be calling me a bum, but I'm still out here having fun. Jesus loves me, this I know. Keep on rolling with the flow. While guys my age are raising kids, I'm raising hell just like I did. I've got some wild and crazy friends who forgive me of my sins. You can't take it with you when you're gone, but I want enough to get there on. No, I ain't ever growing old. Keep on rolling. No, I ain't ever growing old. Keep on rolling with the flow.
Charlie Rich, man. Very good. Very good.
Hey.
Garrett Ford is our guest. This is Made in Texas Live in Studio. How did you decide that you had the voice to sing? Because you got it. You got it, but
karaoke machine they bought me and my brother and two or when we're, it was after the first Tim McGraw concert went to the first concert, and they just bought the little cheap machine from Radio Shack.
Yeah,
when we were little, that was so much fun playing around. It's funny now that would not keep the attention of a kid.
No, not at all.
We have a brother who's 10 years younger than us now, and he's on Fortnite and everything, and there's no way that that would capture.
How many in your family?
Three boys. So I'm the oldest, and then I have one under me, 16 months, and then little Dustin, who's 13.
Okay. And the parents are doing well? They're in Wimberley, too?
They're in Georgetown.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Yeah. That's
they've
right.
got just the one left, but he keeps them busy. When he was little, we would always joke around. The babysitters always had to wear tennis shoes because they're going to be running.
Nice.
So, but
that's
he's
fun.
He's in middle school football right now. That's what he's going through. He's probably doing 2-a-days right now.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, that definitely.
Did you play ball at all?
I did. I did the weirdest combo you could think of. I did swimming and football.
Well, okay, I get that.
It was, I did endurance one half of the day and the other, and my body was like, pick, what are you doing?
What'd
but
you play?
It was fun. I was let's see here, safety, and then I was puncher.
Okay.
Found out the kickers had to practice kicking during wind sprints, so I got just decent enough to be second string punter, just to miss that.
Yeah, that's an odd way because, you know, you're trying to avoid the sprints, but at the same time, you're jumping in the pool later.
Yeah,
so,
that was worse, honestly.
Would you swim in the pool?
I honestly liked all sprinting events because you're out quick. I would do the 50 free or 100 free.
your dichotomy there is spectacular. Avoid the sprints for football, but nothing but sprints for swimming. Yeah. I love it.
Yeah, it's a good point.
Where can people keep up with you? Where can they find you? Where can they get more Garrett Ford?
Sure. I post on my website, so everything's up to date on tour dates. And that's also as well, I'm pretty active on Instagram, and I'll put dates on there as long as Facebook too. And then I'm also on Bands of Town, and that'll upload. And so I make sure to always keep plugging in or let people know where I'm at, you know. And looking at, you know, like I said, branch out, start playing all the markets of Texas and have fun. It's always fun. You never know who's going to come out the door and come see you. So
yeah,
I'm always looking.
Very good. Where would you really like to play? Where is like your number one place that you want to get to and play live?
For me, I think it would probably be where I was in high school seeing all these bands, and I'm like, that's what I want to do. And that was Nutty Brown Amphitheater out in off 290 out there in Austin was fun for me. We would always go to the Wednesday Night Free Texas Live series, and that's where I kind of really got my big old introduction to seeing all these cool Texas country bands and all that, and it's a cool venue and stuff out there. So I always thought that would have been fun to maybe one day open up or play out there, do a big old show out there. I think that'd be great.
Garrett Ford has been our guest. Thank you for coming in, man.
Yeah, it's been so fun.
And congratulations on the album release.
Thank you.
Woke Up in Waco is the title. Get it, find it, add it to your list. You can find it on Spotify, all the major distributors, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. Garrett Ford, right here on Made in Texas Live in Studio. If you've missed any of this conversation, it will be up on our website, madeintexasradio.com, coming up on Monday. From all of us here at Made in Texas Radio, y'all have a great evening, and thanks for hanging out. This is Made in Texas.